Magandang gabi. Hello, good evening. Magandang gabi means good evening because I'm broadcasting from Ohio, USA. Yes, this is Albine. Let's learn Tagalog. Magandang gabi from Ohio, USA. And if you are in Asia, magandang umaga dyan sa inyo, Asia. Good morning, Asia. Good evening, America. Yay! Welcome to Learning with Albine. Yes, and because we are learning Tagalog, let's learn or practice Tagalog here. Okay, problem statement. What root words accept affix um? Okay. Second question. What root words accept prefix mag? Third question. How to understand the nuance between and mag verbs? Fourth question. How do I use verb in a sentence? Okay. Next, how do I use mag verb in a sentence? Okay, that's our problem statement for today, and I bet that is what you would what I think that is a good topic for us to learn today. Yes. Hi, Kelly. Yes. Mabuti ako, Kelly. Yes. Kumusta ang lahat? Hello, Damien. Yes, I'm happy you're back. Yes. And it's about affixes for today. I hope you are doing good, Kelly. Doing good. Damien and Ibrahim. How's Ibrahim? Thank you for being here. Let's stay put, relax, enjoy. And again, I would say this kind of topic is going to be series of episodes because these are about verbs. Yes, and we want to make the video, every videos shorter, so I need to really cut it in short and proceed again another episode. Pandiwa is verb in Tagalog. Yes, this is already our lesson proper. Feel free to raise questions, but let's focus on Tagalog verbs, especially and mag, as defined in the video title, right? Pandiwa is verb in Tagalog, and let's quickly define what verb is. It is the soul of the sentence because it provides essence to a phrase or a group of words. Okay, so this group, this part of speech we use to express movements or actions, movement. That's why whenever I refer to verbs, I do think this thing. Yes, action verbs. Okay, next slide. Yes, Kelly is good. Thank you. Yes. Yes, and let's just an introduction to verbs. Yes, and if this is for Kelly, Kelly, this is just a review for you. Okay, but that's good also. And if you are new in Tagalog, that's all right. It's nice that you get started with verbs also. Yes. Yes, verbs. This I will try to make it a beginner level of lesson for you if you are new in Tagalog, and to those in intermediate level, let's do review. Okay, review for you. Pawatas as infinitive. Yes, if you are familiar with infinitive form, I will have another slide for infinitive, what it means. And then pautos as imperative. Yes, pautos in Tagalog, in English, pautos in English is imperative. Paturol in English is indicative. And then pasubali is subjunctive. Okay, next slide. Okay, so again, I would like to clarify, or yeah, I think that's a good term, clarify. This session focuses on pawatas, infinitive verbs only. So I would say this is a series of lessons. Yeah, and then the coming session would be a continuation of this part. So Not only this session and the next session will focus on pawatas or infinitive verbs only. Yes, specifically, let's talk about and mag affixes. Yes, and mag affixes. Okay, pawatas, of course, infinitive in English, verbs that do not indicate time nor person. Take note of that. Does not indicate time or person. Yes. Yeah, infinitive form of verb. Okay, equivalent to 2 plus verb in English. 2 plus verb in English. Like example, let's do this example. Kumulog. Kumulog. So literally, I would like to define it as to produce a thunder. Yes. To produce, just to follow the format 2 plus verb infinitive. So kulog, root word kulog, refers to thunder. Next, umakyat. So root word here is akyat. So umakyat, to go upstairs, umakyat, to go upstairs. So I had to follow 2 plus verb here, 2 plus verb format. And then magakyat means to go upstairs with something. Yes, to go upstairs with something. So now, early on, you have the hint how to differentiate umakyat and magakyat. Yes, and later, maybe we will clarify that later. Okay. And so, and let's take note that pawatas is the base form of verb. Base form of verb, because it does not indicate time nor person, just is. Okay, let's do next. I like to make it faster again. Let's animate root word. And what happens if you have root word? What is a possible thing to happen? There could be prefix. Okay, so we have prefix. Let's pick a prefix, let's pick a root word, and what to do next. Okay, of course, we have to validate if prefix and root word go together. And then, yes, let's have example. Let's do the root word ulan. So ulan means rain. Ulan. And then let's do a prefix let's animate this example. Okay, so ulan, the root word ulan, what has to do next? Ulan has to find certain affix or prefix, right? So ulan, that's a what in this case, affix, does affix go with ulan? Let's find out. Does affix go with ulan? Okay, so let's see if it will go. I think based on this animation, it's obvious that based on this animation, umulan is the word. So you have the affix, in this case, prefix and you have the root word ulan. So you got complete word umulan. So in this case, umulan is an infinitive form of verb in Tagalog. Umulan. Okay, yes, let's give you a reminder or a key thoughts on prefix or panlaping Let's see. When the root word starts with a vowel, yes, consider as prefix panlapi. When the root word starts with a vowel, consider as prefix or panlapi. Otherwise, is an infix, and the resulting word is a verb. Yes, is a verb. And then example, yes, ulan is the root word. It starts with a vowel. The same thing with araw means sun. And then another one, alis is another word, means leave. And then akyat, go upstairs. And then kulog is a nature of phenomena of nature. Kulog means thunder. And then sumama is another word. Sama means to join or to go with. Okay, later we will have more examples and demonstration. Umulan, umaraw, umalis. These are has become prefix here. Umulan, umaraw, umalis. And including umakyat. Kumulog, sumama, has become infix. Okay, let's do more example. Like for example, kulog. What has to happen when kulog and what needs to be conjugated? Yes, or an affix has to be applied with root word kulog. What is the thing to happen? Let's animate. So we have the root word kulog, and what's next? What to do? Or what do you think the process to do that? Yes, so take note, with kulog you need to separate the first letter of the word, of the root word. Yes, separate the first letter, which is K, and then separate K from the rest, which is ulog here. Yes, and what's next? If we know that we have to separate the first letter with the rest, let's do. So we have one component, which is K, and then you have the second component, which is ulog. Yes, funny. And then what's next? So you have K, and of course you have and you have infix here. Infix, it's not prefix here with kulog. Infix, let's see. So in that regard, K, yes, you got kumulog. So you have to insert the in between the first syllable and the rest of the you have to insert the in between the first letter and the rest of the letters of the root word. I think I have said it right, properly, right? And that's kumulog. Kumulog is the word here. That is how you need to connect infix with the root word that starts with a consonant. Let's do, I hope. And yes, before I proceed, I would like to acknowledge Marikit Fernando. Thank you for your support last February 2021. And yes, and to all my viewers and supporters, of course, you are coming here with me repeatedly. And even if you are watching me on recorded live, I would like to say, please also support Marikit's channel. And she is a fellow student of Tagalog, and she has a YouTube channel, and also she has a book, and the title of her book is Back to Dance, available on Amazon. Okay, I leave it all to you. You know it already. And yes, if you appreciate what I'm doing here, please support, help me maintain this channel or the other stuff that I'm doing. Find the link, buy me a coffee link down in the description, and you will be mentioned next month. You will be mentioned next month. Okay, quick announcement for you. Let's proceed. Yes, thank you for listening to that advertisement, and let's proceed. Okay, unlapping of course, let's continue with the unlapping or prefix affix okay. In this case, I'm presenting all root words. Okay, it's a mix of everything. Mix of word that starts with vowel and word that starts with consonant. Let's do ulan. So ulan means rain, so you have the infinitive verb umulan. So now I would like to define it as Mother Nature to bring us rain. So I would like to use the word to bring because of infinitive form of the verb. Mother Nature to bring us rain. Umulan. And then araw, so means sun. Umaraw. umaraw, Mother Nature to bring us sun. Bulaklak. Bulaklak means flower. So let's apply infix. Bumulaklak. Bumulaklak. Mother Nature to produce flower. Mother Nature to produce flower. Take note again, most specifically applied to acts of nature. Acts of nature. Baha. Baha means flood. Let's use infix. Bumaha. Bumaha. It means to produce flood. I don't know. Maybe to produce is a good verb here for rain. Yes, keep your comments coming if there is confusion. Let's solve it. I will be happy to help you right this moment or maybe later, provided that the topic goes around this and verb. Oh, what? Verbs and mag verbs. Okay, let's do. Or maybe I encourage you to come up with a new root word that you think that is applied. Yes, maybe that's the thing. Please bring new root word where is applied. Okay, next, let's do that. I like to make it faster so I don't stay longer from here. Okay, tango. What does tango means? Tango. Yes, tango. I'm nodding my head. Tango, tango. Tango is the root word, nod. So apply the infix, you have tumango, so to nod. Yes. Now, what are all these about? This page is about to show movement of body parts. To show movement of body parts. Just as simple as that, just to show the movement of body parts. Tango, tumango. Iling, shake hand, umiling, okay? Tingala, look up. There's lizard up there in the ceiling. Tingala, okay? Or infinitive form, tumingala. I hope you appreciate my demonstration here. Ngiti, yes, ngiti, smile, ngiti. So let's apply verb, ngumiti. Again, take note, movement of body parts here. Next, let's do next group of root words. Another application or like idea. Group of root words. It should be a natural action of one's spirit, thought, feelings. Yes, it's so profound, right? Spirit, thought, feelings. So it again, first group of root words that I present to you, it's really so nature like take note of that, very nature like okay. Isip means thought, so you have umisip, so to think, umisip. Limot means forget, so it's like, yeah, something that's brain activity, right? Thought activity. Lumimot, to forget. Tulong means help, so the infinitive form tumulong means to help, okay? And then another example, we have ibig, so feeling, love, umibig, to love. Again, take note, one's spirit, it could be yours, spirit, thought, feeling. It could be mind, spirit, thought, or feeling. It could be others, spirit, thought, or feelings. Yes, so this is the group of what verb for that. Right? Next, let's have another group. The action pertaining to subject's body acting on its own. Take note, acting on its own without others' influence. So again, it's all the, I'd like to emphasize that group of verbs refer to internal aspect of the action, nature-like aspect of the action. Yes, that's the greatest hint for the group of verbs, because that's one of our questions, how to differentiate and mag verbs. So in this episode, I specifically dedicate to verbs, right? Sama is one word, root word. Sama, join or go with. Sumama, to go with. It's individual's decision to join. Yes, it's my decision to join or to go with. It's your decision to join or to go with. Sumama, it's your decision to go or to attend to my tutorial. Sumama ka sa tutorial ko. Yes, it's your decision. Sumama, your own action. On its own, without others' influence. Yes, without others' influence. Sumama. Same thing with dalaw. Dalaw, it means visit. Visit. This is an action that me or you would have to do without any others' influence. My decision to visit, my decision to see my friend. Dumalaw. Yes, dumalaw. Also, the same thing with guho. It means, or bagsak. Guho or bagsak, it means fall. So let's use verb so that we mean that it's something. It could be non-living things. It could be this guho or bagsak may refer to a bridge as an example, non-living things, or a wall or fence. Yeah, gumuho, bumagsak. Gumuho, bumagsak. So if you hear that word gumuho or bumagsak, it's really like that action is just by itself, no other influence. Or it could be nature's influence, the reason why. Or maybe like, for example, bridge, like it has weakened a long time, right? Gumuho, yes, bumagsak, yes. And then of course another thing is takas, escape. Tumakas. So just like sumama or dumalaw, tumakas has the same concept, subjects, your own decision or your tendency or what? Your decision, the action that you did without others' influence. Tumakas. Yes, again, let's say this word, and I hope that while I'm saying this word, you are visualizing that object or that person is doing its thing, nature type kind of action, no influence, no other influence, just is. Okay, sumama, dumalaw, gumuho, bumagsak, tumakas. Because later on, I'm going to differentiate, like for example, for the word sama, what about magsama? What is the difference between sumama and magsama? So later, not this session, next session, we will come up with a conclusion. What is the difference sumama, magsama? Okay, to go with, to visit for dumalaw, gumuho, bumagsak, to fall, tumakas, to escape. Okay, and then also, oh yeah, I made it really that short, and I didn't prepare sample statements. Yes, let's continue next meeting. That's the best thing. No questions so far. If there's no question, I will proceed with some key information for you to take away. Yes, with regards to or mag. Hi Damien, are you doing good? And Kelly, yes, there are four people watching, and I really just want to make the video shorter for now. If you have no question, I have to proceed with the next slide now. Okay, and so, but before I have to proceed with the next slide, and while I'm waiting for your comments or questions, yes, or suggestion, maybe suggestion will be nice for later, yes, or for the next episode. While I'm doing that, let me show this one. And please subscribe to my channel, of course. If you are new in this channel, thank you very much, very much. We are learning or practicing Tagalog. And yes, and if you are repeat viewers of mine, please invite your friends if you know people who wish to learn Tagalog. Let's do it all together here and same time next week and the following weeks, right? And let's do you're still doing good. Yes, doing Kelly is doing good, thank you. I can maybe give a little bit of hint as I show you our key information on what is verb and what are mag verbs. Let's do that. But before I proceed with our next slide, please subscribe to my channel and please watch my other videos if you have not watched it yet. Yes, and yes, what else? Join our Facebook group, and I'm on Instagram also. Yes, and what else? Please hit the like button. Thank you for the likes. Thank you so much. And yes, next, and please try my one-on-one premium classes. For more information, get to my website albinebodo.com. Yes, I don't want to stay longer for this page. And yes, I will be sending you all email. I'm writing emails so that you get a good understanding of what I am doing here. Yes, let's do this. Next. Okay, in this series we have all these affixes. So right now we are in an introduction to and later I will deliver mag. Yes, and if you just got in here, please check out my other videos on other affixes, which is ka and other things, ka, kai, ma, and others. And later on we will be discussing other affixes, pag, paki also, and other stuff. Sometimes these are not arranged according to how it's listed, like this and mag. I need to do it today because when we get to pag, we need to understand and mag also. Yes, and pang, something like that, I think, and paki. I think we want to understand and mag first before we get to discuss pag and mag and paki. Yes, and let's do this. Let me bring this to you, wrap up please. You were introduced to infinitive mode of verb this time, those basic infinitive. Again, please remember that infinitive has no aspect of time, or you don't need to consider the actor, or yeah, maybe no person. Yes, no person it doesn't specifically pertain to the person doing it, but it's nice. You would appreciate the use of verbs with imperative form. Later we will do that. And let's do, you were given some root words that affix accept, umulan, umaraw, umalis, umakyat, what else, and other stuff, umisip, umibig. Yes, and yes, this is very important for you to see or to figure out. Yes, the acts of nature for the group of verbs. Yes, this is very important. Acts of nature, natural movement of body parts. So kind of verb that refers to internal action only. Okay, actions of one's spirit, thought, or feelings. Yes, whereas this, from here you would have to understand why mag is spoiler alert for mag group of verbs. Mag is not the same as in this regard, because mag is sort of external. Yeah, it has to go with external aspect of the action, whereas doesn't go with external, only internal aspect of the action. Whereas mag, for example, mag-akyat, yes, umakyat versus mag-akyat, as what demonstrated in my first few slides, umakyat versus magakyat. Let's use that word as an example. Umakyat is just you go upstairs, or that person umakyat. So if you would like to do imperative, issue a command to somebody, you say umakyat ka, umakyat ka. So in English, that means you go upstairs, umakyat ka. Okay, how about magakyat means magakyat ka ng beer sa taas, dito sa taas. Magakyat ka ng bigas. So that means you need to bring something. Magakyat ka. There is an external aspect of the action. Whereas umakyat, just do it, akyat thing. Regardless whether you are bringing something or not, it's just your essence doing it as a person moving from down to up. Second floor, umakyat, only that person doing it. Whereas magakyat, it means you need to bring something. When you go upstairs, magakyat ka ng bigas, magakyat ka ng tubig, magakyat ka ng beer. In English, you bring water, you bring rice, you bring beer upstairs, magakyat. So that is a hint to our next episode, which is mag as opposed to umakyat. Yes, so that is I think that's why you came here, because of mag and but I need to cut it, and we want the video shorter. And one more thing, verbs also pertain to actor's subject. Oh yes, the body acting on its own without others' influence. Without others' influence. Umakyat, another example. Sumayaw, no others' influence. Sumayaw, tumawa, humalakhak also. What else? Bumasa, sumayaw umaral. And yes, and again, for the next episode, I will be telling you which root words doesn't go with mag and which root words don't go with we will find that what group of root words don't go with and what don't go with mag. Yes, and I hope you appreciate our session for today. I've got to go. Yes, I hope that I have given you something today. I am so concerned about that. I am really so concerned, and I really hope that you are getting something from me. Please say thumbs up, please. If you are, say, getting something for me, even if it's as short as this one. Thank you so much. I'm sending love, healing, protection, light, joy, your way. Maraming salamat po. This is Albine. Mag-aral tayo ng Tagalog. Magkita tayong muli.